We can multiply 12 times 25 or any pair of two-digit numbers quickly with a general method. Here's the general method. It looks a little bit like the method for squaring a two-digit number, but after all, it should, because when we square a two-digit number, we are multiplying a pair of two-digit numbers. So here's the way it works. Let's suppose we had 52 times 83. Step one, multiply the units digits. So we multiply 2 times 3 to get 6. Second step, find the sum of the cross products. That means here's our cross product, 16 and 15. 16 and 15, that's not too tough. 15 and 15 is 30 plus 1 more is 31. Right down to 1, carry the 3. Last step, multiply the tens digits. 5 times 8, 40, and the 3 we carry is 43. We're finished. Or would you rather 52 times 83? 3 times 2 is 6. 3 times 5, oh my goodness. I haven't done this in a long time. I'll probably make a mistake here, but no, I got through it. I don't multiply that way anymore. We just want to write down the answer. And granted, you may have a couple of problems where the numbers are rather large. I mean, you know, you could have something like 69 times 97, let's say. Okay, it's going to take us a little bit longer, especially that middle step. But we can get through it, can't we? 9 times 7, 63. Write down to 3, carry the 6. Kind of important. Now, you know, I could do this. I could put down a 6 off on the side here someplace. I don't want to do that. Each time I make a mark on my paper, it's taking time. I want to save that time. So this is easy. I don't have to write anything down. Here's my 6. Okay. I've got cross products of 81 and 43, 6 times 7, 42. 81 and 42. Well, 80 and 40, it's 120. 120 plus what? 3 is 123. 123 plus the 6 I carry is 129. Right down to 9, carry the 1, 2. Carry the 1, 2. Last step, multiply the tens digit. 6 times 9, 54. 54 and 12. That shouldn't be too tough. If it is, take the 12, break it down into 10 plus 2. Okay, so 54. 64 plus 2 more is 66, 6,693. Isn't that nice? Keep doing that and teaching that to your kids. Pretty soon they're going to be challenging those kids from Singapore and Japan and Hong Kong and the rest of them. Now, of course, I know what you're asking. You're asking whether there is a similar process for multiplying, let's say, a pair of three-digit numbers. We're not going to have time, but it looks like this. You take your three numbers, it's five steps. You're going to multiply the units digits. Then you're going to take the sum of the cross products here. And then this is the toughest step. It's going to be the corner products plus the middle, the tens product. And then step four is the opposite of step two. Step five is the opposite of step one. It reminds you again of climbing up a mountain. And when you get to the peak, that's the toughest step, the third one. And steps four and five are much easier. And again, looks a little bit more like a football play than mental calculation. But yeah, there's a seven-step method here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 steps if you want to multiply a pair of four-digit numbers. But again, that's more advanced stuff. Well, I don't care if you're a teacher or a student. That's the kind of stuff you leave toward the end. First, you have to get the computations down that involve a pair of two-digit numbers. What do we have, 5 minutes? 10:30, is it? Okay. Let me teach you a specialized method for the two-digit numbers. I think one of the most useful ones, you know how many times we have to multiply numbers that are in their teens, numbers that begin with a 1? Now, you can use the general method, and the general method is pretty easy, of course, but there's an even easier way. You know that for 13 times 15, it's going to involve four multiplications, 10 times 10, 10 times 3, 10 times 5, and 3 times 5. If I am doing this problem of 13 times 15, I'll let you hear what I am saying to myself as I do this problem. I say to myself, in fact, I'll write it down. I say to myself, 100, 130, 180, 195. In other words, I multiply these two numbers at step one. It's always going to give me 100. I am going to then add the product of 10 times the first digit and then 10 times the second digit. So when I look at this, I think 30 because 3 times 10 is going to give me 30. When I look at the 5, I think of 50 because 5 times 10 is going to give me 50. So 100, 130 plus 50 gives me 180 plus 15 is 195. Or I'm going to say 100, 170, 250, 250 and 56. 250 and 56, 306. Over here, 100, 190, 230, 230 and 36 is 266. Now, if the numbers are presented horizontally, okay, you got 100, 160, 180, 192. Now this one, we're almost out of time. I've got to show you another specialized method. If you're multiplying two numbers that differ by just one integer between, like 17 and 19, what, we know it's 18, right? All you have to do, take that middle integer, and assuming you know it's square, if you don't know it's square, it's not going to help you. But if you know it's square, if you know what 18 squared is, 324, all you have to do, subtract 1, 323. Does it work for 13 times 15? You bet it does, because the middle number is 14. 14 squared is 196, subtract 1, 195. Works like a charm. So we can use that. That's called teen multiplication. And we got 2 minutes. You can also do it in reverse. If you want to multiply any pair of two-digit numbers that end in a 1, like 61 times 21, 60 times 20, that's 1,200, 1,260, 1,280, and it's always going to end in a 1, 1,281. 300 times 700, 2,100, 2,130, 2,200, 2,201. 80 times 40, 3,200, 3,280, 3,320, and it ends in a 1. So it's a great shortcut there. I wish we had another 2 hours or so. We could lock the door on Joe Ellen and stay here longer. We could send out for pizzas, whatever you want. I have all sorts of material that could keep us going all night. The one thing is, if you really are interested, they're all in the book if you care to buy a book. Otherwise, I'm repeating this session in about 5 minutes, but I'll be covering most of the same material. When I get to about this point, maybe I'll do a few different types of specialized methods for squaring or for multiplication, but other than that, it'll basically be the same. So I hope as teachers you go out there and teach the kids the speed math so we can finish a little higher than 28th place the next time. Okay? Now, don't forget, as you're leaving, take a copy of a handout, and anybody who might want to buy the book through the mail, again, you got the application on the back. Otherwise, I've got copies here, and if you think your school might be interested in having a speaker, take one of these, especially if you think the speaker would be me. But other than that, you guys were a great audience. Thanks for coming.